Hello everyone, welcome to ViteConf. Did you know there's a myth where if you say performance 3 times, your code will instantly get 10 times faster? Turns out I tried it, but it didn't really work. So that I wrote this talk up so that I could like teach you some of the performance tricks that I learned myself instead of that weird myth. So let's get going to that. So I'm gonna talk about some kinds of performance, ways to identify them, ways to measure them, and then to fix them. And I'm gonna show you some examples of the journey like so far what I've learned. And to start off, the characteristics of performance, there are many characteristics. So identify one of them is making it efficient. So we do things directly and minimally. And they're also doing things less, using less code to do the same thing. And there's also resourceful, which is using like what's available in your runtime or environment to do the things that you need to do. So quick examples here, you have, you know, instead of using like the map, filter, and then reduce, you could just use a simple for loop to and an externalized variable to do the same thing. While like environments could optimize the dot map filter reduce, sometimes it's better to do things more directly and just ease the environment to do more what you need to do. Another example for less is that, you know, if you're only using a subset of library features, maybe you only can use like a different library, which only do that thing specifically. Or maybe you could implement your code if it's much simpler and you don't have to handle a lot of edge cases. So that's one example you could do. And another one is like using worker threads to run heavy tasks in parallel so that you don't overload the single thread. And that kind of reminds me of this meme where, you know, core one is doing all the work and then the other cores are like not doing work. So this is like the kind of performance that you could expect. And then sometimes they overlap between each other. And to identify the opportunities, I think there's many ways. One of the type of opportunities is something that's vague. So vague opportunity is something where your customers or your library users tell them that something feels sluggish, or something takes very long to do an action, maybe your NPM install just too slow. So these are kind of vague opportunities where there is like a clear problem, but you don't really know where to start. And then on the other hand, you have like more specific ones where, you know, something, an input causes an unnecessary re-render, the server takes a long time to process like certain data, or you have like a lot of large dependencies in your node modules. So these are specific things that you could nail into and to debug. So something that's actionable. And ideally what you want to do is to turn these vague opportunities to something specific so that we can act on it. And there are different many tools to do this. These are the kind of tools that I use myself. And there's probably more, you could check it out. So I have some screenshots here where this one is the Chrome DevTools. And this one is the performance tab of the Chrome DevTools. This is the Firefox DevTools. This is perf.link. So the fourth one here. There's also some Node Inspect, BRK, and Chrome Inspect, which I'll show later in the examples, which is something I also use quite a lot. And there's also this one. This is packagephobia.com. And this is npm graph, which is very helpful for me to debug in the dependency graph in Node modules. And there's many more here, which I'm not going to show, but you could check it out. And you know, find what works for you. So the next thing is to try to figure out where you can improve your performance, which is probably the hardest part when you try to do this kind of work. But I'm gonna show some examples here. So usually my flow is that I work with Node projects more often. So with Vite apps, Astro apps, something. If you're using like a website or an app in the browser, maybe you have a different workflow, but most of the time it's going to be working similar like this. So I run the project with Node Inspect BRK, which is something I showed you. It will look something like this, where you start the Vite dev server over here, and then it's going to wait for me to listen. I open up Chrome Inspect. It will have like an inspect here, which I'm going to click on, and then a dev tools pop up. It's going to show the performance tab. So this one is where I'm going to record the performance of the app. It's going to auto start the Vite dev server right in this terminal here. And then I'm going to do some things and then record it and then end record. And then I'm going to download the profile, the CPU profile here. And I'm going to show in speed scope. So this is a website that I find very useful, especially the left heavy view here, which I'm going to show later on, that you can identify the heaviest part of code that's taking the most time. So yeah, this is one of the PRs that uses that flow. This is, I think, one of my first PRs where there is a package that resolves package.json files, but it is a very generic library that resolves any other files as well. So I realized maybe you could like, do it directly maybe something simpler, just like an idea. And then in the end, got up to 4 times faster performance. So it is efficient and less. And the way they debug it is something like this. So before CPU profile, I noticed that there's many like file system operations going on. You can see there's a lot of things going on. Overall, it takes like 1.5 seconds over the entire build. And then after that, after this, you notice that there's much less file system operations going on. Overall, it takes like around 600 milliseconds. So a lot of things are just trying to observe like things, something like before, things that are just weird and things that you think that you could optimize better to a specific task. And then just try to compare it and see that, you know, it improves performance overall. And this is just one way of it. There's another example here using worker threads. This is not a PR by me, it's from Safi, who implements using threads for processing CSS files. So if you have like a lot of CSS files in your app, you might be a bit slow. The processing will happen in the main thread will slow down. So if you offload it like to a worker thread, you're gonna use more of your CPU cores, it's gonna be faster. So in some apps, Safi found that it was 1.4 times faster. So this is pretty neat. In the end, this is like a very resourceful performance optimization. It's using all the cores in the app, in your laptop. And this is probably one of my hardest optimization that I've done, which is to reduce memory usage. So this one, and it doesn't use the performance tab of the Chrome profiler, it uses the memory tab. So what I did in the past is just recording the memory, and then it gives a lot of entries for each object or strings that's taking up memory space. And just most of the time, I'm just like figuring out what's going on. Why is it occupying too much memory? So in this PR, I realized that, you know, there's every AST in all the modules, when Rollup bundles it and connect things in node modules, it keeps in memory altogether. So I realized that you could reduce it so that you don't have to keep everything in memory and only compute it dynamically. And overall, this is just quite of a difficult task, which is not always easy when you do performance work. But in the end, it uses less out of memory errors, which is awesome. And this is so quite a resourceful, using less memory so that you could have more memory for different operations. And then the last example I have here is something that not my idea, I think it was Chris and Emma was trying to figuring out. When you're doing static site generation, you don't really need like to stream the HTML to the file. So you pretty much only need the string and then just write to the file. So this is what it's actually doing. So in this case, it's not really about performance and benchmarking. It's more like an idea where you just think about this problem and just think about maybe like different ways to do it. And so performance is not always about measuring, but sometimes you need to put in more effort to figure out some ideas. But at the end of the day, the ideas pay off. It gives 26% faster performance, which is awesome. And makes, yeah, things a lot more efficient without breaking everyone. And this is just one of the different ways to figure out like the performance when you're doing performance work. So at the end, there's some considerations when doing that. There's an ecosystem and community. So some considerations that, you know, every improvement compounds no matter how small. Sometimes you're gonna expect like 10 times improvement, 50 times, but sometimes you're gonna be like only 10%, which is a bit unfortunate. It happens to me quite a lot of times. But at the end of the day, this thing compounds. So you shouldn't really be discouraged if something is not as big as you hope. Because at the end, it might help in the future where you have maybe less memory usage. It's gonna help in the future, so everything counts. And you should always compare the trade-offs. Make sure that you're not sacrificing a lot of maintenance or readability or the stability of your app if it's becoming like a big problem, if like someone else is working in your project as well. So this is something that you should take into account. Make sure you use what works for you, and there isn't like a silver bullet for everything. And there's also the ecosystem community. So performance work like this is a bit difficult. Everyone who does performance work will try to share what they can, including, I think, Marvin here, who wrote a blog, which is one of the first blog that really helped me kickstart off doing performance work, because I wasn't really like familiar with the tools back then to need to do what to measure this. And this helped me quite well. And then there's also another blog here, which I linked to, is one of the performance work we did for 4.3, which I showed earlier as well, one of the VPRs where you can dig into something more in depth in how we figure out like certain optimizations. Things like this are pretty helpful. So if you can share of that, it'll be pretty good. because it's where I learned from as well. And then in the end, you could also join like a community of like-minded folks. So in the past few months, me, Batak, Anthony, and James created E18E, which stands for Ecosystem Performance. You can join in chat.e18e.dev. That's where we links to a Discord server. I learned quite a lot from there as well. There's a lot of many like very knowledgeable folks in there who was teaching, like giving ideas, giving like advices, which are is pretty nice. So you could check it out as well if you're interested in this kind of work. And thank you. I hope you enjoy the rest of ViteConf. There's a slides there and a repo if you want to check it out. Thank you. Bye.